Hey guys, welcome back to another video. In today's video, we're going to build a little magnet motor here. So this is intended just for fun. We are not trying to prove any kind of free energy or anything. We're just exploring the idea and kind of showing here what 3D printers can print and what you can make or prototype with these kind of machines here. So hopefully you guys enjoy this video. So let's get started. Alright, so I got two 3D printers. I got the Monoprice I3 Mini over here, which I got on eBay for $100, which was a great deal. And then here is my second printer that I got, and this is the Ender 2, and I got a really good deal on this one also. Sometimes they have deals, so keep your eye out. You can get a pretty decent printer for a good price. Alright, so here I have a magnet motor, and I think it's called Perendev magnet motor. I'm not sure exactly how to pronounce that, but it's supposed to be like a, you know, free energy device where you put the magnets in and it spins. But the reason I wanted to build this is because, you know, just to explore the fact, I've always had curiosity about these things. So this is just for my interest, mostly for you guys to see, you know, how you could print things out and build things. So I downloaded this kit here from Thingiverse, and I'll leave a credit up here if you want to download it yourself and try it out. So most of these parts were printed on the Monoprice here because that was the first printer I had. So I wanted to print something more substantial, and I printed this. And so this is the maximum, or almost the maximum volume here that, well, not volume, but I guess dimensions, depth and width that this printer can print. This is a 118 millimeters. So these were printed on the Monoprice. These were printed on the Monoprice. I don't know what you call these, stators or whatever, also was printed on the Monoprice. So the only thing that was printed on the Ender 2 here is the rods that you see right there. And the reason for that is because this one can go all the way to 200, while this one can go about 100 millimeters tall. So these rods are 150 millimeters. So, and they are not perfect. Hopefully you can see that, but there's quite a bit a wobble that happened on the top whenever this thing would print because it's so thin. It would move around as it went up, making it a wobble and kind of messing up the print. The good part is it'll still work, or at least for this concept that we're building. I wanted to use as much 3D printing parts as possible. So we're just going to go what we have and hopefully it all works out. So the other two things that we have that are not 3D printed are these bearings here, which we're going to need to go into the ends here. And obviously our little magnets right there that'll go in all these little holes that you see here. All right, so the first thing I want to see is if these bearings will go in here. I don't know how good the tolerance are, but let's go ahead and try to put one in here. So they appear to be really tight fit. So all right, so our bearings are in and everything's good. So all I had to do is just tap them a little bit, so no big deal. So I think the next thing we can do is go ahead and put all the little magnets into the little slots here. So I'm not sure where the polarities are supposed to go, but so they seem to be fitting in there okay. They're definitely with some resistance, so I'll have to push them in there. So getting all this stuff back out is definitely not going to be an option. Okay, so if I use pliers, they go in there really good. All right, so now I'm just going to go ahead and put them all in. Well, it looks like most of them are going in, so I'm going to go ahead and put them all in. All right, so the magnets are all in, and it's looking pretty good. So now I just got to put the rest of them in the same way, the same polarity, and then we'll move to the rotors. All right, so all of our stators have magnets in them. Pretty cool. So let's move to the rotors. So the stators have 8 magnets in them, and the rotors have also 8 magnets. So technically they all line up together. So what we're going to do for the rotor is we're going to put it where it is opposing this one. So we're going to put same poles facing each other. And so whenever it's in there, it's always trying to fight it. So here we go. All the magnets are in the rotors. So that's pretty cool. So that'll be all the magnets that we need for this setup here. So out of curiosity, let's get one of these stators here and see what happens if we just put this in there. So I'm guessing they need to face each other. Do they? Oh gosh, check that out. There's like a dead zone in there. You could totally move around like this easily. Look at that. Dead zone. But then if I twist it, see that? Oh wow, that's a lot of resistance there. But I love how there's a dead zone. That is unique. That actually could be like a gearless gear, I guess. I don't know how you call this, but you can put really decent amount of torque right here. And this is one of the reasons why I like to research this stuff or look into it, because you get ideas from it, even though, you know, it's not obviously going to work as it's intended. Just the design, you know, has interesting implementations for other uses maybe. So imagine if you needed to power something, but you didn't want the friction of gears. So you'd never have any gears that wore out because it would be magnetically coupled. All right, anyways, so that is interesting. So I think we have pretty much everything ready to go. Oh yeah, I did forget to mention that I did call this thing PM01. So the next thing we need to do is we need to connect all these three together. And that is done by these guys right here. Just like that. And as you can see, they're all leveling themselves out because of the magnetic field. So there you go. There's another thing you can learn from this is, you know, you can make magnetic springs. If you just stack the magnets in the same polarities and then have a shaft, you can have an actual magnetic spring. So you see, guys, even though how ridiculous these models are, you know, you can learn quite a few things just by, you know, building them, and maybe you get ideas for more real world use. So that's kind of cool. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to use some super glue to glue all this stuff together. Super glue is easy and fast. The tolerances on all my rods and little holes here are kind of bad. And the reason I did that is so I can have a little bit of play here and there if I need it. And it appears to be pretty good right there, so I'm just going to leave it. It's close enough. And we're going to wait a few seconds, and then we're going to center this guy here and glue him about right there. All right, so we got all this glued, and it's gluing up really good. It's not perfect, but it's close enough. Should be fine. So the next thing we want to do is we probably want to work on our rotor here. All right, so here you can see all the rotors on, and I didn't realize, I guess I didn't look into too much, but we have a timing adjustment slots right here, and I didn't print anything for that. It might be too small to print that anyways. Probably have to use something metal there. But in any case, what that's for is that, let's say you wanted to have the rotors offset the magnets here, I guess. Let's say in this kind of staggered way. But for today, we'll just leave it like this, and I'm not sure what to do with these exactly. If I put them together like this, you know, we're just gonna get really strong dead zones, and then, you know, pushes and then dead zone, pushes and dead zone. So I think the offset here matters also. All right, so I glued the rotors to the rod here, but it all turned out pretty straight, so. Okay, so the idea here is to get these two pieces together now. So they shouldn't be too hard. Together pretty easily, just like this. Let's see what happens. All right. And this is what we ended up with, guys. Check it out. It's pretty awesome looking. So obviously everything is a little bit crooked. You know, our rotor doesn't spin so straight. There you can kind of see, got some wobble in it. But overall, everything is, you know, operational. So, and the cool part is it all looks pretty good and all the pieces went together all right. Now, dealing with these rods was a little bit hard because they're 3D printed and everything's not that perfect. But it all glued together pretty well, pretty easily. So I think if you'd use metal ones, that would make it a lot easier. But, you know, because this is a 3D print and we're trying to use as much 3D printing as possible, you know, we still ended up being pretty nice little motor here. So the moment of truth is what happens when you put them all together? Nothing. Nothing happens. It does push it out because it doesn't want to be there. But if I put it in there and I try to spin it, it has a lot of resistance. It's trying to spin, kind of. But, you know, obviously nothing's happening. Honestly, I was not expecting it to work. It's not that I don't believe that it can work. It's just I don't believe that this one would work. Because if it did, everyone would be printing them out and having a little motor there. But in any case, it's fun to build something like this and to learn. And mostly just to, you know, have on the shelf as a little show-off piece that your 3D printer printed. Honestly, if I took a little bit more time and care with how I built this, you know, it would look a little better and at least more precise. But because I had to glue all the pieces, we're off a little bit here and there everywhere. You know, the rotors wobble a bit. These are offset kind of. But at the end of the day, we do have a really, really cool controversial little piece here. All right, guys, and this is the Perendev magnet motor. So as you can see, you can have a lot of fun with these 3D printers, and you can really build anything your mind can imagine. So if you enjoy building things and prototyping and, you know, just designing things, 3D printing is the way to go. So if you guys enjoyed this video of this little motor I built, then hit that like button. I got a lot of more interesting things coming, and also I got more 3D printers to unbox. So if you want to see more and you're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.